In Spanish, Puente de Santiago. In Tagalog, Muag ng Santiago. Fort Santiago is a citadel first built by Spanish conquistador Miguel Lopez de Legazpi for the new established city of Manila in the Philippines. The defense fortress is part of the structure of walled city of Manila, referred to as Intramuros.
St. James the Great, which means Santiago in Spanish. He was the patron saint of Spain. His relief was to adorn the fay gate of the first gate. It is located at the mouth of the Pasig River, and it was used as a premier district fortress of the Spanish government during their rule in the country. Let's now explore Fort Santiago.
Entering the gateway, one could immediately see the outer plaza called Plaza de Armas or Plaza Morriones. It was designated as parade and drill grounds. The mode was added by Santiago de Vera, Governor General from 1584 to 1590. He also added the stone breastworks along the riverside, an arc entryway with a relief carving of Santiago de Matamoros dominates the inner court. Other governors continued to improve its defenses so that it is probably the best laid out portion of the walls. Plaza de Armas was the fort's main square. It is surrounded by the military barracks. To the north side of the plaza was a barracks, which is the probable site of the wooden fort of Rajas Ilocan. Filipinos lived under the Spanish rules for more than 300 years and were greatly influenced by Hispanic culture, religion, languages, family ties, and social mores. Over the years, it served as an open-air stage by several performances by BECA, Philippine Educational Theater Association.
The left side of Las Armas, first thing to see is the brick wall ruins, which were originally part of the oldest building in the port and built in 1593. And the structures were made for the Spanish soldiers, and during the World War II, the family and the army officers were destroyed.
Now we are here to Medyo Baluarte de San Francisco. It is former headquarters of the Philippine Division of U.S. Army, occupied by the Japanese military in 1942, where the hundreds of civilians and guerrillas were executed, imprisoned, and tortured, declared as the Battle of Manila in 1945. It is used as depot of U.S. Transportation Corps before turned over to Philippine government in 1946, declared a Shrine of Freedom in 1950. Restoration and maintenance of the fort began in 1951 under the National Park Development Committee.
Jose Rizal's attention cell, with a representation of Rizal sitting on a desk. In this cell, Jose Rizal was detained prisoner November 2 to the morning of December 29, 1896, falsely charged with rebellion, sedition, and for
complex. The poem, Mi Ultimo Adios, was written here and hidden in a lab that was later turned over to one of his sisters.
He said, and I quote, "Man ought to die for his duty and his convictions. I maintain all the ideas that I have expressed concerning the state and future of my country, and gladly, I'll die for her, night, to obtain justice and tranquility for you. I have always loved my poor country, and I'm sure I shall love her until my last moment. Should men prove unjust to me, I shall die happy, satisfied with the thought that all I have suffered, my life, my loves, my joys, my everything, I have sacrificed for the love of her. I wish to show those who deny us patriotism that we know how to die for our duty and convictions, to foretell the destiny of a nation, if it's necessary to open the book that tells of her past.
Come da poca picchita va bene, si tu la parla miezza americano, quando si fa l'amore sotto la luna, come da lei non cave di I love you, papà l'americano.